Hi friends, please subscribe my channel for technical training and placement related videos. And if you want more updates on my videos, please click on bell icon. Thank you for subscribing. Hi friends, welcome to Elevate Training Solutions. Today we are going to discuss about dynamic memory allocation functions. So you know very well, we have had four variety of dynamic memory allocation functions in C. What about Java? What about C++? What about Python? We'll see all the four languages, how we are going to allocate a memory for the variables as well as the objects, right? First, we'll see how the memory allocation is going to happen in the C language, right? You know, we have four memory allocation functions, right? The first one is the malloc. See, this is the malloc, this is a function is used to allocate a memory. Malloc and calloc, both functions are used to allocate the memory. Coming to the realloc. Realloc is a function is need to reallocate, means either increase or decrease. Either you need to increase or decrease. For that purpose, you are going to use a reallocation. Coming to the free. So you need to free the memory manually. You don't have an option for the automatic. But Java and Python, both languages support memory deallocation by default, means this is the automatic garbage collections is there in the Python and as well as the Java. Even C++ also you need to deallocate a memory manually, right? This is called as a destructors. First we will see the C language memory allocation. C is malloc and calloc. You may have a doubt, sir, what is the difference in the malloc and calloc? So which one you need to use? So I'll give the more clarity on these two functions. See, the malloc takes a one argument as your one argument, it takes as a input, and it takes a two arguments. That is the difference between the malloc and calloc. So we'll see the practically. See, first we'll see the malloc. Here what I'm going to do, here I'm going to allocate a memory using malloc. See, this is the normal pointer variable. For the normal pointer variable, I am going to allocate a memory. How much size? Integer, right? So the size of the A is 4 bytes. You know, the size of the integer is 4 bytes, right? So we are going to use the size of int. Means by default, it takes a 4 bytes, right? If you execute the program, see, you didn't store anything. You didn't store anything, just you created a variable. And when you create a variable, so it created like this. Created like this. So this is a star A. It has a one memory location also. It has a one memory location. For example, you can take it 2000, right? So you didn't store anything in a malloc. So see what happened. If you execute the program, So what I told you. So here it takes only one argument, right? Malloc takes only one argument. That is why. So earlier I have given the two arguments. That is why it generated an error. Now it is only one argument. If you execute the program, see, I got some garbage value, right? So please remember one thing, if you allocate a memory using malloc, it takes by default value as a garbage value. This is a very, very important bit, and this is a tricky question also. So what is the value is assigned when you create a dynamic memory allocation variable using malloc? It takes a garbage value. Please note that one. Right, so by default value of malloc is garbage value. Let us see what happens if you change the same function using calloc of one variable. See, if you execute the same program, here the value is 0. Please remember this one. If you create a memory using calloc, by default value is 0. That is the difference between calloc and malloc. Malloc takes one argument, calloc takes two arguments, right? As well as so malloc by default value is garbage value, calloc by default value is 0. That is the most difference between the malloc and calloc. See, if you consider here, for example, here malloc is there, right? For example, here I'm going to take 10 into size of int. Okay, so here if you execute the program, see, I'm going to create 10 variables, right? 10 variables. For example, if you take this size of a, if you execute this one, oh, I forgot this bracket, right? See, 8 bytes means by default it can take only this pointer size. Is not the array size. Remember this one, it is not like the array size. Even if you take the here character, and here you change the character, if you execute this one, still it's shown 8 only. It's a character size, so it is a pointer size. Don't it is a character or integer, it is not the size. Okay, so this is the purpose of CLock and malloc, right? What about real lock? See, if you allocate here 10 integer variables, right, but you need to reduce the size of, for this size is going to reduce by using realloc, right? Realloc of, so here I'm going to take 100. I'm going to increase the size, right? Yes, it's a long, right? Right. So by using realloc, you need to reallocate the memory. Means either increasing or decreasing. That is the purpose of realloc, CLock, malloc. What about free? Free is a function is used to release the memory, whatever the memory is allocated. By using free function, you can delete the memory. That's all. See, the same thing, if you print after this, just execute this one, still shown the 8, but the memory is assigned. The memory is released. 80, right? So some negative value, some garbage value, right? If you execute this here, same thing. Observe carefully. These are very, very important bits in placement point of view. See, minus 96 and both 8, minus 80. Both are the different garbage values because we release the memory, right? Free is a function is used to release the memory. This is the purpose of the four functions we used in C language. Please remember, it takes a one argument, two argument. By default value is garbage value. Here the value is 0. By default value is 0. Right? Reallocation, either increasing or decreasing the memory. So coming to the free, to release the memory, right? Next, memory allocation in C++. How memory allocation is going to happen in the C++? Using allocation using constructors and deallocation using destructors. You know, here the allocation is two ways. Remember one thing. The first one is, suppose I'll show you one thing. See, class A is a one class. Suppose if you create a class like this, this is a static way of creation object, static memory allocation is simply called as a static memory allocation. For example, same thing, if you a equal to new of a, then it is called as a It is called as a dynamic memory. So it's a stack. Here the memory is stack memory. Here the memory is heap memory. Here the memory is heap memory. That is the difference between new. New is a dynamic memory allocation. So it's a static way of creation. It's a static way of creation. That is the main difference. But if you want to deallocate the memory, so just see the deallocation of memory. Suppose if you want to deallocate this memory, simply you can use a constructor. So this is the constructor creating a class name with the tilde operator. A class name with the tilde operator is used to deallocate the memory. Whatever the allocation. So you know, when you create an object, memory is allocated. When you, if you want to deallocate the memory, you should use the tilde operator with A. Then when you call this function, so by default the memory is deallocated. By default the memory is deallocated. Okay. But when you coming to the Java, when you coming to the Java, you don't have a deallocation separate function. Here only one way of creation objects, that's a dynamic way of object creation. Dynamic way of object creation. It doesn't support static way of object creation. Remember the this one. Objects are created using only dynamic way, because so you don't, you cannot create an object like this. You should use a new operator. Should use a new operator to create a object. To create the object. That is the difference between C and C++. Sorry, C++ and Java. In Java, you can create an object only dynamic way, right? But in C++, you can create either dynamic way or heap memory or static memory. Dynamic way or static way. So both difference between the Java and C++. Coming to Python. Coming to the Python. In Python, we can allocate allocation of using stack memory, heap memory, this is a dynamic memory, static memory, and release is by default. Here also, release is by default. Means automatic garbage collection. Automatic garbage collection. You don't have any, in Java also, you don't have any special functions to deallocate the memory. So by default, automatic garbage collection supports. Garbage collection. Right? So the unused objects, by default, it deleted. Like our memory. Our memory is also same, right? So if you don't use something, some concepts or some your friends' names, okay, so after 10 years you may forget their names or their memories, right? So by default your memory supports automatic garbage collections. Like that, Java and Python also supports a automatic garbage collection, right? Coming to the Python language. In Python language, see, it allows object variable creation static and heap and memory list by default. I'll show you one small thing in C. For example, 10 is a variable, 10 is a value, right? And also some k equal to 10. I want to know what is the reference of 10. See, here we don't have any separate memory, separate addresses for the variables. Here addresses for the values. Here addresses for the values. See, id of 10. If you see the id of 10, 10 is a 10, the value of 10. Here, this is the value to refer the 10th value. This is the address, is refer the 10th value. See, for example, id of k. K is a variable, right? You stored 10 value, right? So both are the same. See, both are the same. Now, the same. That, what is the k stored? K stored 10 only, right? 10 only, right? So if you check the id of, I mean, there is a reference of, what is the reference id of k? Means the reference id of k is 10, as well as 10 is also 10. Means what is the value in the 10? Right? For example, here I am going to change the k value is 11. Then see, if you check id of k, I got a different value, right? So in Python, please remember, it is not dependent on variables. It is dependent on the values. Python depends on values, not for variables. Not for variables. Please remember this point. Please remember this point. This is a very, very important, right? Okay, next I am going to show you. See, k equal to 10, this is a static way of creation. This is the static way of creation. So what about dynamic way? For example, k equal to 0 into 10. See, this is the way to create a memory dynamically. See, if you print k, this is the dynamic way of creation. So here it uses a heap memory. Here it uses stack memory. That is the difference between the stack and heap allocation of memory in Python language. Okay, is this clear? If you have any doubts, please comment on my video. Definitely I'll help you regarding this. Okay, so most of the interviewers are concentrated in what are the dynamic memory allocation functions and what is the difference between constructor and destructor. Constructor is allocating a memory, destructor is deallocating the memory. But you don't have a destructors in Java. By default, it supports a garbage collections. Coming to the Python also, we don't have any destructors, means deallocation memory. So by default, Python supports a garbage collection, right? Is this clear? So if you have any doubts still, you just comment on my video. Definitely I help you regarding this. Okay, thank you. Hi friends, please subscribe my channel for technical training and placement related videos. And if you want more updates on my videos, please click on bell icon. Thank you for subscribing.